Back home, outspoken Senator Jacqui Lambie has weighed into the Woolies racist singlets drama, claiming the slogan doesn't go far enough. Lambie has been critical of the supermarket's decision to pull the if you don't love it, then leave T-shirts from shelves, adding that those who don't love Australia should be deported. Many have taken to Woolies' Facebook page protesting the removal of the T-shirts, saying that they aren't racist. Fiona, what do you think? Do you think this is a racist T-shirt?
Oh, yeah. It's bizarre. I've not heard of it before.
Well, I think the thing with it, it's not just the message.
While you were having a meeting, I was sleeping.
But it's a very sort of confrontational, aggressive thing. It reminds me of a couple of years ago at the big day out. There are a bunch of drunken Bogan idiots running around. I love Bogans. Sorry, that's slagging off Bogans. But idiots going around. That's right, I'm Bogan
too. Take the deal!
Going around with the Australian flag and shoving it in people's faces and saying, kiss the flag. Wow. And if people didn't kiss the flag...
That's a bit different.
No, it's not a bit different. It's issuing the same challenges. Basically, it's going around saying, do you not love Australia? Do you not love Australia?
I think the problem with this whole debate is that everyone has assumed that by saying, if you don't like it, leave, that we are talking about people from the Middle East. And that's why this has become the sort of discussion topic it has. Years ago, when we used to bash POMs, excuse me, I love British people, but, you know, you are called POMies. And we used to talk about whinging POMs. And you know, they used to get quite upset about it. We're not just talking about a certain race. It's a T-shirt, I think, that said, or slogan that said, to everyone, if you don't like Australia, leave.
It's antagonistic.
No. I think
yeah.
so too.
That's right, it is. It is in this climate. Yeah. It is in this climate.
Yeah. But I think Anta has a point because reading through the hundreds upon hundreds of Facebook messages that we had on our show's page, a lot of people feel like they'll bring up a lot of in the comments that, you know, Christmas pantomimes were being cancelled because they were deemed offensive in schools and that type of thing, which is why there's this underlying sentiment in the community.
But to me, that's totally different. I mean, I've thought a bit more about this particular singlet this week. And I suppose it's not racist in terms of it's not singling out a particular race for ridicule or abuse. But what I fear with that kind of slogan is it's xenophobic and it's kind of plays into the whole us and them. And I think, Joe, you were kind of right when you say it's kind of almost this aggressive undertone.
Well,
and
that's right. It's clearly directed at someone, saying if you don't love it, leave. So who's the you in it?
Exactly. It's been around for a long time.
But it's divisive. And also, you say you think about the big day out. I see that and I think about the Cronulla riots in terms of people draping themselves in the flag, having this sort of misguided nationalism that you've got to love the flag and you've got to be like this. And if you don't, well, then...
When you take out Australian citizenship, correct me if I'm wrong, I think you do say you give allegiance to the country, and I think the flag might even get in there, or it's assumed that you do mean the flag.
But don't
you? I love the flag. But the T-shirt should just say, I'm very happy with the flag, and God, all the new designs are just absolutely horrible. And I don't like this whole hand-wringing thing saying, oh, we're just a nation of racist bogans. I don't subscribe to that either. But a T-shirt that is directed at some imaginary person that basically is saying to them, you know, you don't love Australia, or if you know.
But it has been withdrawn.
Yeah, that's right, and sensibly so.
I don't remember any flags in my childhood or even Australia Day. Become
the flag in the school playground.
Let's look at some feedback coming in on this issue. Lots got you fired up. I love my country, but I don't like some of the things happening here. That doesn't mean I need to be deported, says Ellen. And then there is this, I don't mind the shirts. To me, it's honest, but at the moment, the timing isn't particularly great. My husband had a shirt like that at one stage. I think we have one more. Just a point as well, Jacqui Lambie, mate, she made in her press conference, she said that the shirts aren't as racist as some of the things that ISIS are saying, and which are, if you don't like it, you're dead because we'll chop off your head. So, yeah, she does need to stop talking.
Yeah, well, nothing as racist as ISIS.
Well, maybe not.